is this the kind of bar chart that you want to create, but this is the kind of boring bar chart you end up with? Well, the good news is today, code-free, we're going to walk through every step you need to make amazing bar charts. Hi, my name is Anne from Adair-Major Consulting. We help businesses turn their data into insights. And today I'm going to show you all the tips and tricks that I use to create next level bar charts. Let's get started with the basics. There are three main types of bar charts in Power BI. First up, the clustered bar chart. So for example, sales by country. This would straight away show you that it's easy to compare performance across markets. Next, a stacked bar chart. Same data, but now each bar chart is broken down by segment. This shows us composition. So for example, within a region, we can see how the segments add up. And finally, the 100% stacked bar chart. Here, we're no longer looking at totals, but proportions. Now I can see what percentage of each country's sales come from the different segments. Each chart type answers a slightly different question: comparison, composition, or proportion. So picking the right one depends on the story that you're trying to tell. We can even start with something really simple like sort order. By default, categories are sorted alphabetically, but I can switch that up depending on different values and choosing between ascending and descending. For example, if I swap out the x-axis for dates, then Power BI is going to let me choose to organize them chronologically. So next up is labels. There's data labels and total labels. So if we start with data labels, you can see that I can change where they're positioned or even add a text background so that there's more contrast. I've turned on the data labels and the total labels. So in this case, they're the same number. But what I want to do is highlight here that you can see that you can change the formatting. So one is showing in thousands and the other in millions. While in formatting, I can bump up the font size. And for the legend, I can move it around, adjust the font, or even remove it completely since the category labels are already clear. Then there's colors. Right now, each category has its own color, but I can also make the default so that they're all the same shade. But sometimes you want to call out one value, so I can change the color of one single column. Here, I've highlighted government in orange. I can even fade out the other bars so that it focuses entirely on that one. Depending on your categories, bar charts can feel a little bit overloaded sometimes. I've got an example here of sales by product, and though this one isn't too noisy, I still think I can tell a much better story. Instead of listing all my products, why not highlight the top N filter? Top N standing for the top number. So I can decide how many I want to see, measured by a value of my choosing. So if I change the filter for just this visual to top N, I'll pick sales as the measure and we'll say top three. Now the chart only shows the top three products by sales. It's a really clear way of telling a story to your users. Instead of drowning in data, you just show what matters. Another way to change perspective is small multiples. So we'll use a bar chart of sales by product and then drag country into the multiples. Now I get a set of mini charts, one for each country. Comparing this to the stack chart we saw earlier, which is the same data, it answers a different question. I can see how each country contributes to a product. With small multiples, I can flip it and compare across countries more easily. And swapping between small multiples and legends is just drag and drop and easy to explore. So, for example, what about segment in small multiples stacked by countries? Instantly, I can see the government segment dominates, followed by enterprise. And exactly what countries are driving those sales. It feels advanced, but it's just one field dropped into small multiples. Now, still in the format pane, using reference lines, I can add a constant line for an average profit. Immediately, it's obvious which periods are performing above or below the average. I can rename that to average and show it as a thin gray line, changing the label to show in millions and putting the line behind the bars. So I can even shade the area below so the chart really tells a clear story. Instead of just showing raw numbers, this reference line gives you a benchmark, a quick way to spot what's strong and what's underperforming. We touched on colors before, but conditional formatting brings this to the next level. Here is sales by country, and in the format pane, I can choose conditional formatting. I'll set it to a gradient by sales, choosing the smaller values to have a light blue and the higher values to stand out with a deep navy. And when I apply it, it really brings the chart to life. Another amazing way of looking at conditional formatting is about positives and negatives. So why don't we swap out the sales for profit? And I can take this even further. Instead of gradient, I'm going to use rules. Green for a strong profit, red for a negative. I've added a slicer here by segment. So for all the segments with a profit, it's green. However, the enterprise segment has made a loss, and that is highlighted in red. This isn't just decoration. It's about a quick way to surface where the business is thriving and struggling. From these examples, I hope that you can see the bar charts are one of the clearest ways to compare values across categories, making it really easy to spot the biggest, smallest, or standout performers at a glance. They're especially useful when you need to show differences, rankings, or contributions in a way that's quick for your audience to interpret. So that's how you take your bar chart from basic to brilliant. Now, what I suggest next is Drillthrough. Drillthrough lets you keep your design really clean and simple, but gives your users the ability to dive into the data where they want to. I'm going to leave my video here on how to implement Drillthrough. Again, it's code-free, really easy. Check it out.